I had some major goals in mind, and one of them was to have a veterans monument and also to have a museum to honor our veterans.
There was always a dream of our people to have something here to host our history in the way our community was built. You'll see later on after, when you pass through the museum, how Doquiswa was formed. We have areas from the logging days, from the French River. We have an area for our veterans. We have our maple syrup. We have a little section of our first church. We come around and you'll see after how we evolved as a community and use all the items. You'll see one, the first thing you'll kind of see is our birch bark canoe. And one is still coming to be hung up. So it's a great honor, and I just want to give recognition to these three fine ladies up here that worked so hard, and some of our youth and our young adults, and that hours that they put in putting up displays, all the history that was researched. It's great when it's something our community have taken at heart and put together. So as you go through, maybe you'll have ideas, or you'll say, oh, I have something at home, or I remember this at home, and I would like to put it here. And that'd be a great honor for us to receive those items. So I just would like to say for Denise, and Veronica, and Marie, and Sharon, and I thank Marty for being here. So we're going to do the opening, or the grand opening, of the ribbon, but I will give the honor to our deputy chief, Denise, because all her hard work has brought this to fruition. So, Chimigwech to you, and Miigwech to everyone that's here.
Ta-da! Drum roll!
We are raising our flag because this is our first time for this flag pole at this location, and Clayton, who's served in the Canadian Armed Forces previously, will raise the flag.
We're standing on this pad that was made, and you see one of the our pots, Yokikenda, what our true name is. We were fortunate enough to bring one back on this side to show everyone what the meaning of this First Nation is. So when we stand upon it, when we look at it, it's all that force that comes with it.
the trials that we go through, the river that flows, the rock that gets caught and makes a hole. And our ceremonies are made always in a circular way. There's no beginning and no end. And it also represents us as a community, young and old, and we're still here and we're still growing.
In Sanders Field. In Sanders Field, the poppies glow between the crosses row and row that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks so braving, singing, fly scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Field. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high. And you break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep till poppies grow in Flanders Field.
So the first monument here and there will be for Pierre and also the family of Geraldine Lestor, who served 23 years in the Canadian Armed Forces. We proudly unveil this monument in their recognition for their service to their country. So please unveil.
You weren't needed because we're just them. I just want to acknowledge the woman who worked so hard for this day to come. The museum, brand new museum, and all the community that worked so hard to bring this day today. But most of all, I want to bring three or four women that worked so hard. They also, could you come up here, please? Denise? Veronica? Stand right in front of me here. Now, these are the three women that did the job. I'm going to tell you, they're strong, powerful to do all this. Denise, my wife, Veronica Dickies, and Marie, my best friend, Jim, my kid. She's the buggest one. She bugs me all the time.
Good job.
But anyways, I also want to say, which is very important, because these are the three women here that designed that building. They did it on their own. And when you go in there, you'll see how it's designed, how it's built, and they're the ones that did it. I say miigwech to them and everyone here today. Miigwech.